This video is about systems of linear equations using the Gauss-Jordan method. A linear equation could have a lot of solutions for x, y, or z, but when it has become two equations or more, it becomes a system. Therefore, there could only be one solution since the relation of each equation to each other should be considered. In this case, the Gauss-Jordan method could be used because it is an algorithm for looking for the solution of the systems of linear equations. The Gauss-Jordan method was written by Carl Friedrich Gauss in his book, which is why it's named after him, even if it was presented much earlier without proof by Chinese mathematicians. It was him who actually gave proof to this method. This was further popularized by William Jordan because he introduced the reduced row echelon form. Gaussian elimination uses row echelon form, wherein the principal diagonal has leading ones and all the values underneath that principal diagonal is zero, while Jordan introduced the reduced row echelon form, wherein there are zeros under and above the principal diagonal with leading ones. So the reduced row echelon form looks like an identity matrix. The goal of Gauss-Jordan elimination in solving systems of linear equations is, first, represent the linear equation as an augmented matrix, which is the matrix of the coefficient of the system. Second, we would reduce by row operations by using either row swap or exchanging two rows, scalar multiplication, wherein we multiply the row by a constant, or by row sum, where we add a multiple of one row to another. Lastly, we express in reduced row echelon form, or the form with zeros above and below the principal diagonal of leading ones. Now let me show you how we express a system of linear equations into an augmented matrix. In this example, the first equation is negative 3x plus 2y minus 6z is equal to 14. The coefficients are negative 3, 2, and negative 6, which we are going to put here at the first row of our augmented matrix. So negative 3, positive 2, negative 6, then our constant 14 would be placed at the other side of the vertical bar. Next, let's do the same for our second equation, 4x minus 5y plus 2z is equal to negative 3. But this time, let's put it at the second row. So positive 4, negative 5, positive 2, and our constant negative 3. Lastly, for our third equation, 7x plus 9y plus 3z is equal to 14, let's put the coefficients at the third row. So 7, 9, 3, and our constant, which is positive 14. So here we have it. This is our augmented matrix. So again, for the Gauss-Jordan method, our goal is to turn the augmented matrix into a reduced row echelon form such as this. As you can see in this other system of linear equations, the augmented matrix has been turned into a matrix in reduced row echelon form with leading ones in the principal diagonal, zeros in the lower triangle, and zeros in the upper triangle. This part here then corresponds to the values of x, y, and z. Since the first column corresponds to x, it has a value of 1 in the first row, so that means x is equal to 2. Now, since the second column corresponds to the variable y, it has a value of 1 at the second row, so y is equal to negative 1. Then z corresponds to the third column, and it has a value of 1 in the third row. Therefore, z is equal to 3. We usually solve a system of linear equations using either substitution or elimination method. Let us compare elimination method to Gauss-Jordan method. We are given x plus 3y is equal to 7, and 3x plus 4y is equal to 11. In the elimination method, what we'll do is multiply the first equation by negative 3 to cancel the x variable and be left with the y variable. When we do that, we now have negative 5y is equal to negative 10. Now to get the value of y, we could divide it by negative 5. So we'll get y is equal to 2. Now for the last part of our solution, we could also multiply the second equation y is equal to 2 to negative 3 and add it to the first equation. Since y is cancelled, then x would be equal to 7 minus 2 times negative 3, which is 1. So the value of x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 2. Now let's use the Gauss-Jordan method to solve the same system of linear equations. First, we need to convert the system into an augmented matrix. So let's put our coefficients for equation 1 into our first row. X would be 1, 3y would be 3, then 7 for our constant. Then, let's put our coefficients for our second equation into the second row. So 3x would be 3, 4y would be 4, then our constant 11. Now, let's do row operations to make this augmented matrix into a reduced row echelon form. We already have our leading one for the first row first column, so we need to make the second row first column into 0. To do that, we could multiply the first row by negative 3, then add it to the second row, and that would be our new second row. So, negative 3 times 1 plus 3 would be 0. Negative 3 times 3 plus 4 would be negative 5. Then negative 3 times 7 plus 11 would be negative 10. So this would be our new row 2 after doing our first row operation. Now, our second row, second column, must also be 1. To do that, we could divide the second row by negative 5, and that would be our new second row. So when we do that, we would have 0, 1, and 2 for our new second row. Lastly, we need the first row, second column, to be 0 as well. So we would multiply negative 3 to the second row, then add it to the first row, and that would be our new first row. So negative 3 times 0 plus 1 would still be 1. Negative 3 times 1 plus 3 would be 0. Then negative 3 times 2 plus 7 would be 1. So as you can see, this is already the reduced row echelon form. Since we put the coefficient for variable x in the first column, therefore this 1 corresponds to x and x is equal to 1. Then y corresponds to the 1 in second row first column, which means y is equal to 2. So x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 2. Now if we look at the two methods side by side, we could see some similarities. For elimination, first we multiply the first equation by negative 3, then added it to the second equation to eliminate the x variable. While for Gauss-Jordan method, we also multiply the first row by negative 3, and we also added it to the second row. Second, in elimination, we divided our now second equation by negative 5, which we also did in Gauss-Jordan. We divided the second row by negative 5. Third, for elimination, we multiplied the second equation to negative 3 and added it to the first equation, which we also did in Gauss-Jordan. We multiplied the second row to negative 3 and added it to the first row. So both methods gave us x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 2. It's just that the elimination does operation in equations, while the Gauss-Jordan method does operation by rows and columns. Now let's proceed to a more detailed example. For our second example, we are given x plus y minus z is equal to 7, x minus y plus 2z is equal to 3, and 2x plus y plus z is equal to 9. Let's get right into expressing our given equations into an augmented matrix. The coefficients for our first equation are 1, 1, and negative 1. Then let's place our constant at the other side, which is 7. For our second equation, it is 1, negative 1, and 2, then our constant 3. For our third equation, it is 2, 1, 1, then our constant 9. So the orange part for the lower triangle should be zeros, the blue part, or the diagonal, should be 1s. And the red part, or the upper triangle, should be 0s. And then this green part right here are gonna be the values of x, y, and z. Now from our augmented matrix, let's make 1 from second row first column into 0 by subtracting row 2 and row 1, or simply row 1 minus row 2, and that will be our new row 2. So 1 minus 1 would be 0, 1 minus negative 1 would be 2, negative 1 minus 2 would be negative 3, and 7 minus 3 would be 4. So this is our new row 2 after our row operation. Next, from our outcome matrix, let's turn this 2 into 0. And that would complete our reduced row echelon form for our first column. So let's multiply row 1 into negative 2, then add it to row 3. So negative 2 times 1 plus 2 is equal to 0. Negative 2 times 1 plus 1 is equal to negative 1. Negative 2 times negative 1 plus 1 is equal to 3. And lastly, negative 2 times 7 plus 9 is equal to negative 5. So this is our new third row. Next, let's make negative 1 from third row, second column into 0 by doing row 2 plus 2 times row 3. 0 plus 2 times 0 is equal to 0. 2 plus 2 times negative 1 is equal to 0. Negative 3 plus 2 times 3 is equal to 3. And 4 plus 2 times negative 5 is equal to negative 6. So this would be our new row 3. Then let's make negative 1 from first row third column to 0 too. So let's do 3 times row 1 minus row 2. 3 times 1 minus 0 is 3. 3 times 1 minus 2 is 1. 3 times negative 1 minus negative 3 is 0. Then 3 times 7 minus 4 is 17. So now we have our new row 1. In continuation, we are left with 2 more to turn into 0. So let's start with negative 3 from second row third column by adding the second row to the third row. So 0 plus 0 is 0, 2 plus 0 is 2, negative 3 plus 3 is 0, and 4 plus negative 6 is negative 2. Then our last one at first row and second column should be 0 as well. So let's do 2 times row 1 minus row 2. 2 times 3 minus 0 is 6. 2 times 1 minus 2 is 0. 2 times 0 minus 0 is 0. And 2 times 17 minus negative 2 is 36. Last step, let's not forget to turn our principal diagonal into 1s for it to be in a reduced row echelon form. So let's divide the first row by 6 because we know that the 6 here, when divided to 6, would result to 1. Now let's divide the second row to 2 so that the 2 here would result to 1. Then the last row by 3 so that the 3 here would be equal to 1. So for the outcome, we already have our reduced row echelon form. Now remember, we put the coefficients of x in the first column, which means x is equal to 6. Then we put our coefficients for y in the second column, so y is equal to negative 1. Then we put the coefficients for z in the third column, so z is equal to negative 2. Therefore, our final answers are x is equal to 6, y is equal to negative 1, and z is equal to negative 2. So that's it. I hope you learned a little something about solving systems of linear equations using the Gauss-Jordan method. Thank you!